When a boat is born, the Chinese give it eyes to see. They paint the Yang Ying talisman on its sloping prow to give it luck, and curved white fangs to scare the hungry ghosts. Out back of Geylang, at the edge of the Kallang Basin, is a way of life that gets smaller as each year passes. This is the forgotten land, where kampongs get meaner with every step, and the atap huts are so old that they kneel and finally topple into the water. Hidden in a fold of time, the machine age passed these men by. Without a single machine tool, they saw and chop and hack at the hardwood logs brought in from the jungles of Malaysia. They carved them, shaped them, and smoothed them, assembling all the pieces to build boats. These are the artisans of yesteryear. Craftsmen in wood. They sweat and toil in the hot sun until their backs are permanently bent and hands so gnarled that they take on the very contours of the handles of the tools they use. A power saw could rip apart a hardwood log in a matter of minutes. With a handsaw it could take all day, perhaps two. But what is a day? There is always tomorrow. 7 days a week, from dawn to dusk. 12 hours of sweat to saw, to chip, to rasp, to chop. And after one log, there's always another, as long as there are boats to build. In the middle of chaos, the timber is carefully controlled. Highly skilled men appraise each log. The grain is studied, and also the splits in the wood. The log will make planks, ribs, or spars, which will fit into some section of the boat. The hardwood is heavy. With no electricity or petrol engines to ease the burden, the timbers are manhandled into position. Like primitive man, they use the lever and the winch and their own muscles. Thank you. This temple is as old as the boatyard, dilapidated and soon to be pulled down in the favour of God of Progress. It is dedicated to Sing Hong Kong, the terrible lord of the underworld, who rules the black abysmal depths and the 10 courts of hell. The flags celebrate his birthday. Inside the temple, all is ready for the religious feast. Robes of the medium are displayed on the red dragon throne. The hopes and the prayers of the devotees rise to the courts of the immortals on the ascending smoke. At one time, the temple ruled the boatyard. No stick or stone could be turned without the blessing of the priests. But the pressure of materialism proved too great, even for the gods. Time spent at the temple was working time wasted, and time wasted meant loss of money, even if only measured in cents. Old men, women, and children will make their offerings to the god. But the boat builders will toil without ceasing. No birthday of a god would be complete without a show. The normal Chinese wayang or opera, with its many players, beautiful costumes and scenery, enacting the adventures of long ago, is much too expensive for the boat builders. They have to be content with a puppet show, constructed high upon the stern of one of their boats where all can see. Behind the puppet theatre, the players and orchestra play on, regardless of the activities below. The medium puts himself in a trance. He chastises his back with a spiked ball. He then rushes out of the temple to the fire made of Bank of Hell money. This is burnt to enable the dead to bribe their way through the courts of hell. Paper offerings to the gods are placed upon the fire. The medium pounds his back with a spike ball to show the devotees that the spirit of God is within him. He feels no pain. As the spirit of the god enters others, they rush around the fire with sacred symbols in a state of trance. The medium puts his foot in the fire to show that he is immune from the flames. Firecrackers are lit to drive away the evil spirits. Soon, two of the five elements that make up the world will come together. wood will meet water. If the evil spirits are driven away and joss sticks offered to the gods, then they will meet in harmony. This boat will have no name. The authorities may give it a number, but impregnated into every timber will be the sweat of the men who built it. And in every drop of sweat is a particle of soul. Collectively, these particles of soul will unite to form the spirit of the boat. Thus a boat is born. With the spirit of the toil of man, with the luck of the Yang Ying talisman on its sloping prow, and with the curved white fangs to scare the hungry ghosts. It will, of course, be born with eyes to see.